almost had a little domestic situation a few minutes ago. See, I wanted to wash one of my vehicles, but my wife seemed to feel that washing the dishes was a better use of my available time and talent. It really wasn't much of an argument because I gave in right away. That's actually an old trick that every high-mileage married man knows. But the beauty of the solution is, thanks to this power washer and a mesh laundry bag, I can actually wash the car and the dishes at the same time. This weekend, it's the big Possum Lake Marsh Gas Festival. I'll tell you, the parade and the dinner and the dance are kind of boring, but the fireworks can blow the roof off. At least they did last year.
I go red! You know what?
Guess what?
I met a girl.
Wow. First the Mars sighting, now this.
I've asked her to accompany me to the marsh gas blowout.
Well, and what does she look like, Harold? I mean, like what's her... How did you fool her, Harold?
I met her on the internet. I don't know a lot about her, but I know she's very pretty. Yeah. And she's a very fast typist.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and get this. She just lives up near Port Asbestos.
Oh, yeah.
The West End.
Oh, Harold, she's got the money, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Wow.
Harold! There's somebody here to see ya.
Girl.
Yeah, all right.
Okay. Can you talk to her for a minute, please? Because I have to go make myself look good.
We don't have that kind of time, Harold. All right, Dalton, let her in. Man, oh man.
Come on in. Good luck.
Yeah, thanks, Dalton. Hello.
Hello, Harold.
Pardon me?
You're even handsomer than your picture.
Harold!
Okay, yeah, I'm all set.
Yeah.
Hello. Who's she?
Who's he?
Right. I know what's happened here. Harold, did you put a picture of me on your webpage?
Yes.
And did you put a picture of somebody else on your webpage?
Yes.
I used my niece's picture.
Okay, all right, here's what we gotta do. We gotta get your niece together with Harold, the real Harold, not this Harold, and that'll solve the problem.
What'll you and I do?
Well, you'll go home, and I'll pray that my wife is not surfing the internet.
Is a coupon for a free stray animal and wall clock from the Possum Lake Flea and Tick Market. All right, cover your ears there, Mike. Red, you've got 30 seconds to get Mike to say this word. Bar! Bar!
Yeah, all right, listen.
Go!
Okay, Mike, this is something that keeps you in a jail cell.
Crummy lawyers.
No, okay, but crummy or not, these lawyers all passed the...
Buck.
Okay. If you know a woman dancer, she practices her leg exercises with one of these.
A fire pole.
Okay. A person who mixes drinks all night tends...
to get a hangover.
No. Okay. This is the greatest surprise you'll get in a hotel room. It has a mini...
skirt!
Almost out of time, Red.
Yeah, okay.
it might, if people want to make something more difficult, they raise the...
bail.
No.
$10,000 for a B&E, which I didn't do. Only I forgot to wipe my prints off the crowbar.
There we go. Today on Talking Animals, local animal control officer Ed Frid is going to tell us all about scorpions.
Not scorpions, Red. Deadly scorpions. Giant scorpions. Giant, deadly, desert, deadly scorpions. They're big and they're deadly and they kill you.
Okay, Ed. Yeah, I think we're getting that. But scorpions aren't native to this part of the country, are they?
If they were, would I live here?
All right, okay, good. Now, I understand scorpions are quite clean creatures.
Oh, good for them.
Yeah. I hear that. I hear they clean themselves all the time.
Oh, yeah,
So, what do scorpions eat, Ed?
Each other. And termites, you know, little termites.
So you drop termites in there?
Yeah.
Well, Ed, this is a wooden box.
It's a wooden. We're all gonna die!
Harold! You know, usually when a guy comes up to me and says, "You're the most creative handyman I've ever seen. How do you come up with all the great ideas?" I give him my stock answer. Step away from the vehicle. But this time on Handyman Corner, I'm going to show you how you can come up with an endless list of creative projects. Because when you've been married as long as I have, you're pretty much out of ideas. I'm actually going to convert these old bikes into a machine that will generate project ideas using only the laws of random chance. And if you don't believe you can make something by accident, just ask Harold's parents. Now, what you want to do is replace the front wheels with back wheels, and that way you can run all four tires from the one set of pedals. Eh? Sadly, this is probably the closest most of us will ever get to owning an all-wheel drive vehicle. The important thing is to pick wheels with different size sprockets on them. That's what gives you the random result. It's kind of like buying a gift for your wife. You pay your money, you take your chances. Okay, once we get the chain all on there, our bike wheels are ready to become our wheels of fortune. And to do that, we need something thick and sticky that everybody has in their home. No, not Pat Sajak. Now on the first wheel, I put all the days of the coming week when I might want to busy myself with a project. Bernice's mother is in town, so I'm going with all seven. Next, I went through the garage, looking at all the different colors of paint I had in the half-empty paint cans and margarine tubs and sample bottles. Then I wrote down the names of all those colors and mounted them on my second wheel. Okay, on this one, I wrote all the raw material I found lying around my yard and the yards of my neighbors who aren't home. Oh, by the way, I find that if you write down two or more pieces of junk on each strip of tape, it really increases the challenge level. And finally, on the fourth wheel, I wrote down the names of a few things that needed doing, fixing, improving around the house. I got them from a list my wife had given me. I couldn't get all of her suggestions on there. Oh, and I almost forgot. On each hub, I've taped a pointer. This is how we read the results from each wheel. Put them all together, and what you have is the Handyman's Random Project Planner. Let's give this baby a spin. Okay, let's see what we got here. On Tuesday, I'm going to build a yellow shag carpeted bird feeder out of a milk crate. Now on Wednesday, I'm installing purple Kevlar storm shutters into the tool shed. And on Thursday, it's a turquoise spice rack made from hockey sticks and a garden hose. So remember, if the women don't find you handsome, they should at least find you handy. Now if you excuse me, I have to figure out a way to wax my car using scuba flippers and a bunch of old ketchup packets. Oh.
Remember, when you make enough deposits, it's time for a withdrawal.
She's awesome. She's fantastic. It's like she's made for me or something, you know? She even knows what I'm thinking. She even, like, finishes...
Your sentences?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And no one does that.
No. Does she have a name at all, Harold?
Bonnie. Oh. Is that short for something?
Yeah, Bonneville. Probably conceived in a Pontiac.
Well, I asked her to the marsh gas blowout.
Yeah?
You'll never believe what she said to me.
Leave out the swear words, Harold.
She said yes! She said yes! She said yes! Yeah! She said yes! Oh, it's so good! Yeah. I'm going with a girl to a dance.
Yeah, yeah.
I still got problems. Relax, would you please just settle down, because I got problems, you know?
All right.
I told her I'd pick her up at 7 o'clock, but I don't have a car or a driver's license.
Well, that's not a problem. I mean, your bicycle has a crossbar, right?
Yes, but no, come on, drive us, please. Please just drive us in the possum van. Please, please.
In the possum van? Yeah. After you said those hurtful things to us for so many years?
Yes.
Well, okay, Harold, but there's only two seats. You're gonna have to sit on the engine.
Oh, no problem. Ever since puberty, I feel like I've been sitting on the engine. Good.
We've gone out behind the lodge there because Walter had a little photo thing set up and we wanted to... It looks like he started at 20 bucks, he's down to... I said, how's business? He got no sense of humor, you know, so I thought, well... All right, so I got the loony out there and, okay, take our picture. But he says, no, these are novelty pictures. You got to put costumes on. Oh, come on. Yeah, he says you can be like a soldier and, or a marching guy or a football, you know, and then Dalton... I said, come on, come on. Give a guy a break. Get in there, get in there. Just put it, it's gonna be a nice costume of some kind. So he didn't have a lot of selection on the costumes. I got the kind of the airline captain thing, and but I think Winston was the real winner. And he didn't want to take the picture right there. He wanted to go over to another field, or I guess the light was better or something. So we go across the street, and so what he's saying is, if you can't see the camera can't see you. So. Winston was the one who was having the real problem there, so he started jumping up and... Meanwhile, Bill was hunting rabbit and thought he spotted the mother load. Now that's not funny, and then... Okay, hey, Bill, come on, what are you doing? It's not a rabbit, Bill, it's not a rabbit. Hi, Bill. Bill, it's not a rabbit. Stop shooting! Bill, stop it! Bill, no! Okay, great, yeah. No, Bill! It's Winston in a rabbit suit. And he's not in the best mood ever. So then we figure, let's get Bill to join us for the group photo. We have one more costume. We think it'd be a perfect costume for Bill. So we get him on, and I think he's looking pretty spectacular, don't you? So now we're all set, but this is taking so darn long that Walter says he's losing light. He needs to get some kind of a flash unit for the camera. It's kind of an older camera, so it has the older style of flash. You know, it's got the magnesium flash powder on there. So he puts that into the tray, and meanwhile, he's left us a little too long in the sun, and tempers are starting to flare a little bit. So Walter comes out to sort that out, and Winston figures, you know, it'd be kind of funny if he put a little more flash powder into the tray, you know? So he goes back and things are settling down, and next thing you know, Dalton goes back and Dalton's figuring, you know what would be funny? If I put a little more flash powder into the tray. And then Dalton comes back to join. Now we're all set, but then wouldn't you know it, Bill slips off and Bill's thinking, yeah, you guessed it. The whole jar. Okay, so and then Bill gets back into the group. Why don't you skip? There you go. And now we're all set. And probably some of you amateur photographers have always wondered what it would be like if you used way too much flash powder. Well, we're going to solve that mystery for you right now.
Rothschilds take care of your septic system because your waste is a terrible thing to mind.
Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt the Red Green Show so that I may bring you the following important environmental message.
Greetings, campers. Ranger Gord here with another one of my patented wilderness safety tips. How many times have you been out in a one-horse open sleigh with a load of props for your own animated cartoon? When this happens. Well, I don't really have to look, Little Red. I know that we are being pursued by a pack of ravenous wolves. And unless we lighten the sleigh, they're going to be all over us like cougars at closing time.
Oh, hurry up, Ranger Gord! They're gaining on us!
I don't know. We're gonna need all this stuff. I don't know. I don't know what I can spare.
Oh, gee, I don't know. How about these for starters?
Those? Those were my mom's, Little Red. Listen, boys and girls, it's never a good idea to make important decisions when you're under a lot of stress. Luckily, I earlier made a list of all the cargo in order of importance, from most to least. 20,212, Little Red. 20,213, Little Harold. So remember, kids, you don't have to outrun a wolf. Just drop something the wolf will find interesting enough to stop and smell.
Uncle Red, he's not gonna eat me.
Or simply mark as their territory.
Oh, hey, cut that out.
Come on, Harold, we're ready to go here.
Coming!
Man, I gave up waiting for Harold there. He's been in the shower for 7 hours. We either need a second bathroom or a closer tree. So I said, the heck with it. I went up in the possum van, picked up Bonnie on my own. So as soon as Harold's ready, we're good to go. Oh, boy.
Okay, I'm all set.
Yep.
Should we go pick up Bonnie?
I've already done that, Harold, and I can certainly see what you like about her. So she's out there waiting in the possum van right now.
What?
Yeah.
How rude is that?
Well...
We have something we'd like to ask you together.
All right, fine.
Oh, Bonnie! Sweetheart! Can you come in here a minute, please? You have no idea how to treat a lady, do you?
This is a mistake, Harold. Like a perfect couple. You're gonna save a fortune on mirrors, Harold.
I'm pretty excited. No, I.
Just had your first coffee?
No. This is my first date.
Bonnie, this is for you.
Oh, Harold, it's beautiful. You pin it on me.
Perhaps, Bonnie, you would like to do it for yourself. Please.
Okay, we're good to go. And what time do you want me to pick you guys up? I'm asleep by 10, eh? So.
Mr. Green!
Yes.
Harold and I were wondering if maybe we could drive ourselves. I've got my license.
Well, I don't know. I mean, the possum van is a pretty big rig, you know.
Oh, Uncle Red, Bonnie is a licensed commercial truck driver. Yeah. She drives an 18-wheeler for Port Asbestos Cartage.
Well, hey, great, hey, go for it.
Don't even, oh, okay. I just want to hold on. I can almost stop your skirt here. You get him. Okay, all right. Okay.
Okay? All right, you go have fun. Don't do anything I wouldn't do, huh? Is watching. I'll be coming straight home after the meeting. Harold has a girlfriend. I don't know how serious they are, but if they ever get married and have kids, it's the end of the world as we know it. For the rest of you, thanks for watching. On behalf of myself and Lover Boy and the whole gang up here at Possum Lodge, keep your stick on the ice.
Meetings come in order. Sit down. Sit down.
Yeah, here we go.
Up, rise.
Quando, Omni, Flunkus,
Moritati. All right, men, bow your heads for the man's prayer. I'm a man
that I can change if I have to, I guess.
Well, men, we've all heard the story that there's a man for every woman in this world and vice versa. And today, we have proved that beyond a shadow of a doubt. I don't miss him either.